There's a Plum Curculio, for example. This is what kicked it all off for me. It's in charge of probably most of the fruit loss in the United States. You can lose 80% of your apples. The weevil flies in, it overwinters in like the woods or in a wood pile or wherever, tall grass. It flies in right when the apples are at like 10 millimeters, so not very big. It flies in and it'll sting the apple. And by sting, it means it deposits eggs into the apple. Either the apple right then has the chance to outgrow it and smush the eggs in the apple, or else it doesn't succeed and the eggs hatch and the little larvae makes its way to the embryonic center of the apple and it eats the embryonic seeds. The apple tree knows right then it can't go on. Its number one purpose, an apple's number one purpose, is to provide seed. And so the apple tree will drop that fruit. And that's when the life stages really kick in. So you have a certain amount of time once that fruit's on the ground before that larvae emerges and heads into the soil to pupate, and then it comes back out as an adult and starts the whole cycle again. Conventional ways of going about it have been spraying broad-spectrum insecticides, which kill a lot more than just Plum Curculio, and I've never been okay with that. And then organic realm is to spray a kaolin clay called Surround, which is also just messy. And so I wanted to go see how far I could get without spraying kaolin clay. And so, I started putting in pigs at certain time periods to catch that drop. And it drastically reduced the amount of Plum Curculio I had in the orchard. So that's like where I started. And then from there, realizing that you could use pigs as a tool, or poultry as a tool, or even cattle as a tool. Learning the different ways, really thinking through the problems of the orchard, and trying to find solutions that could be addressed through livestock.